Hi, my name is David Randle. I'm part of the SOLIDWORKS team. I'm actually on the strategy team with inside SOLIDWORKS. And I am focusing currently on topics surrounding augmented and virtual reality, artificial intelligence, and communities as well. I really look forward to talking with you about how all these trends are going to impact not only us within SOLIDWORKS, but other people within our industry as well. So augmented and virtual reality. So I'll explain a little bit first about the difference and also why they're similar technologies and why we categorize them actually as a fairly new term, which is called extended reality or XR. Augmented reality talks about scenarios where you can place digital content into the real world as an overlay. You can do this via different headsets that are available, like Vuzix and Meta and the HoloLens from Microsoft as examples. We can also do it via devices like iPads, iPhones, other tablets. So these are ways that you can overlay something virtual, whether it's a 2D object or a 3D object, into the real world. The other is virtual reality, where it immerses you into an entirely digital world. So instead of overlaying stuff into the real world, you are now literally inside an entirely virtual space. So they're very related technologies. They typically tend to have the same workflow in terms of how you get content into those environments, but they're for different use cases and they serve different purposes. So that's the difference there. When I talk about XR, extended reality, I'm talking about both of those at once. And we do that because, again, the pipelines to get data into both is very similar. I think these are going to be very fundamental tools to improve design, engineering, and ultimately our cultures moving forward, both internally within SOLIDWORKS as well as for our customers. Even when we talk competitively, our competitors are doing stuff in the space as well. So generally speaking, we see these technologies really advancing our capabilities as a race significantly. Some examples to talk about are some workflows that our customers have told us are really important to them, and so those are areas where we're focusing on specifically. One of those is pre-sales, sales and marketing use cases. So people come to us saying, we're already designing and engineering and ultimately even manufacturing your products using the SOLIDWORKS pipeline, but now we want to use those same tools and that same process to start selling and marketing our designs and our products as well. And there's not a real good way to do that. You can generate still images with visualizer animations, things like that. But people want to take it to another level. People want to immerse their customers into much more emotional experiences. And that's where AR and VR come into play. So that's one of the main use cases we're focusing on. Another big use case we're focusing on is obviously design review. Very natural for designers, engineers to do as they're developing a design. So that allows you to understand, interact, perceive something that you're inventing in a much more realistic manner because it's presented to scale, it's presented in context in a particular environment, and you can just get a much better perspective of that overall design or object, or even multiple objects, if you will, and how they're connected. Part of this as well leads into collaboration. So one of the beauties of AR and VR is that they're really tied nicely into collaborative environments where you can start to allow multiple people, either internal stakeholders or customers or whoever, from all around the world or in different office buildings, to come together in one space to talk about and evaluate a single design or a single topic. And there's a lot of value in that. And there's not really been anything besides things like Skype and GoToMeeting and things like that are very 2D that allow you to have such a meaningful conversation around a digital object. So we really think collaboration is going to be a big part of the next wave of AR and VR. Lastly, we've been getting a lot of feedback that people want to use that same design process. So the idea of making a model, evaluating it, simulating it, and ultimately getting it ready for production to also train their users or train their customers on. So there's a lot of complex complex machines, complex locations where things get installed, complicated devices that require training. And it's been proven that interacting with a virtual object that's 3D, that reacts to the changes that you make or reacts to the steps that you perform, leads to much better retention in that education. So we're getting a lot of feedback that people want to use that same process and establish training data or training sets or training exercises as well. One of the really cool things when we talk about these three main workflows is that literally today on the show floor amongst our partners, we have a full ecosystem of partners that are supporting a new data pipeline that we just announced today called Extended Reality from SOLIDWORKS, which exports a particular file format called GLTF. And that GLTF file is supported by all these partners to actually take that data right out of SOLIDWORKS and build amazing applications that do training, that do pre-sales and marketing, that do collaboration, that do design review, all based off of your SOLIDWORKS data. So that's a very relevant topic today, you know, and that's, I think it's cool that I get to share that information with you because it's fresh. Obviously, there's going to be a bright future behind this. We're literally just getting the momentum going with these technologies. We're just starting to kind of use our brand influence to build an ecosystem to kind of drive this forward. And that's bigger than us, which I love. You know, it's more important than solving our own needs or our customers' needs. It's about moving the whole industry forward and moving, you know, ultimately humanity forward with better tools to do better things, safer things, do things quicker, do things more effectively, do things more efficiently, so on and so forth. You know, ultimately, we want to enable our audience to build the future now, including you guys. So the other topic I'm really excited, and I consider myself very lucky, actually, to be one of the few within at least our company that gets to start exploring this topic, is AI, or artificial intelligence. It's a very relevant topic. You're starting to hear it pop up when people refer to technologies that the big five are investing in, like Facebook, Google, Apple, Microsoft, Amazon with Alexa. So it's one of those trends that's really starting to amplify very quickly. And I'm very fortunate. I just came out of a course specifically on AI, actually. So I have I was very inspired about this topic, and I can now apply it directly to our business. A lot of what we're doing is very early. You know, we're talking about doing early research. We're trying to identify opportunities to differentiate ourselves with artificial intelligence, both in terms of our customers and our interactions and providing services to our users in the products as well, and then within our business. So in my opinion, artificial intelligence has the opportunity to affect literally our whole business and ultimately our whole ecosystem that surrounds us and the industry as a whole. You know, it's going to be, I think, one of the more impactful technologies that affects our generation now and moving forward. So I can't speak to specific examples of what we're doing with AI. There's a lot of opportunities we've identified. There's a lot of dreams we have on what we think we can do with AI and how we think we can make accelerate building the future now. So, you know, that's already saying we're doing it now, but we think we can even make that faster and smarter with the right applications. But, you know, to give a few examples, there's things we can do with our community interactions, such as understanding our users better and being able to serve our users more relevant content, smarter content, help them when they need help the right way, versus having them, you know, self-discover or go and find that help themselves. There's things we can do in terms of making recommendations for what they should do next based on what they've done in the past. And this is just scratching the surface. These are just a few examples of what we think we can do with regard to our community and our services through AI. The next big thing is within our software tools. You know, we have a breadth of software tools, everything from CAD creation to simulation to visualization. AI is going to affect every one of those tools. And we can do things like make suggestions to improve the design, to reduce the weight, to make it stronger. In fact, we saw an example of that today as well with one of our partners who showed the live model. It's from Desktop Metal, or Live Part, that's what it's called, I'm sorry. So Live Part from Desktop Metal starts to incorporate artificial intelligence into the construction of a very intelligent design, which takes into account, you know, the effect of pressure and forces over time versus just statically. And it makes something account for a range of forces versus just a particular load. So that's one example of how that's going to affect products. You know, we can do things like recommend what things work to construct the perfect image or the perfect rendering of a car for someone. You know, and if somebody doesn't know what those settings are, we can say, hey, this worked, or these settings worked for this user to generate this result. We think that you could do the same with these settings. And that's not just for visualization, that could be for other areas of the portfolio as well. And so, and then there's our business as well, which I can't speak much about that yet, but there's vast areas internally within our business that we think AI can impact, including optimizing our business systems, optimizing the way we store and handle data, security, safety, you know, things like M&A research, you name it. You know, there's all sorts of aspects to our business that can be improved by AI. Again, we're not even scratching the surface yet. I don't know what we're doing. It's whatever is before scratching the surface. So we're just getting into it. But we see a tremendously bright future with introducing these technologies into our ecosystem.